हेलो पेरेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड. सो एज वी डिस्कस्ड इन द लास्ट वीडियो, आवर टुडेज वीडियो विल बी ऑन हाउ टू स्टार्ट राइटिंग द अल्फाबेट्स. सो इफ योर किड्स हैव ऑलरेडी प्रैक्टिस्ड द स्ट्रोक्स दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, देन द राइटिंग ऑफ अल्फाबेट्स इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी इजी. सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड.
सो लेट्स स्टार्ट राइटिंग ऑफ अल्फाबेट्स. सो एज यू सी, आई हैव रिटन हियर फर्स्ट 15 लेटर्स. सो यू माइट बी थिंकिंग, why 15 letters? We have 26 letters in English alphabet, then why to start with only these 15 letters? See the 15 letters first. I have written A, E, F, H, I, K, L, M, N, T, V, W, X, Y, Z. So why is that so? Why B doesn't come after A? Okay, why there is a gap like after K, L, M, N, there is no O, P, Q, R, S, then T comes? I will tell you the reason. These all 15 letters are based on the line strokes. Okay, line strokes means what? That we have studied, right? The standing line, sleeping line, right slanting line and left slanting line. So all these letters are based on those four line strokes which make the kids to write the alphabets in the easiest way, right? Because wherever in these letters you will find only these four line strokes, no curve or nothing. So it will be definitely easier for them. How will it be easier? I will show you now. Okay.
So parents, as I told you, let's start the video. Whenever you teach your kid, don't forget to write that particular date. What happens in this? The first thing, they will be disciplined, and whenever they grow, they go to the upper classes, they will not forget to write the date. Okay, and the other thing, you will also remember in the last time when did you teach your kid, which makes you more responsible. Oh, few days back only I have taught the kid, let's start teaching. Okay, so this is the reasons you have to always put the dates. So the first letter is A, right? So how will you teach them? Put three dots like this and tell them while writing: slanting line, one more slanting line, one sleeping line in the middle, slanting line, one more slanting line and one sleeping line, slanting line, one more slanting line and one sleeping line, slanting line, one more slanting line, one a sleeping line in the middle. And when you leave them practice, you put dots like this, so it will be easier for them to write it. After few days they write in the dots, they will start writing by themselves without any dots. So the next letter is E. Parents, please ignore my handwriting. So how will you make them write E? Similarly, you tell them to write a standing line and three sleeping lines. How will you tell them? One standing line, three sleeping line. 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 Now comes the letter F. How will you tell them to write the letter F? One standing line, two sleeping lines. One standing line, two sleeping lines. One standing line and two sleeping lines. So similarly, all the letters, whatever the letters we have discussed, all the 15 letters, you can make them practice like this. But parents, remember, you have to always put the dots for them. Okay, so that the practice will be easier and they will not feel hesitated to write them. So always put the dots. Now there will be, how will you do? So the suppose the letter A, you take the letter A for 5 days. Let them write the letter A for 5 days. Then letter E for 5 days. Letter F for 5 days. So make all the 15 letters to write all the, suppose once you finish the 5 letters, I will show you how. Suppose you have finished writing A, E, after you finish, make them practice the 5 letters like A, E, F, H and I. Do one thing, you more 5 days, don't move to the other letter like K or L, don't move to the other letter. These 5 letters, let them practice. You put the lines like this and let them practice. Okay, so do this whole page, let them practice this thing whole page for 5 days, okay, or or half half you can divide and half in the morning, half in the evening. But let them write this 5 days. After they completely independently write all these 5 letters, move to the other letters like K, L, M, N. Okay, so you can practice in this way. So this is the good method you can follow. So parents, these are the 15 alphabets you should start teaching your kids in the first phase. Why? Because these all letters are based on the lines. Okay, it can be standing lines, sleeping lines, slanting lines. Okay, so it will be easier for them to do it with. Okay, you can see A, 2 slanting line, 1 sleeping line, E, 1 standing line, 3 sleeping lines. So while you teach your kid, make them understand that suppose A, they have to put 2 slanting line, 1 sleeping line. So you keep them saying while they write, so that it will go to their mind, and while they write independently, it will come to your mind. Okay, mama said 2 sleeping line, 1 sleeping line, 2 slanting line, 1 sleeping line. So which makes their work very easier. So please follow all this. Definitely they will write it better. So parents, these are the 15 alphabets you should start teaching your kids in the first phase. Why? Because these all letters are based on the lines. Okay, it can be standing lines, sleeping lines, slanting lines. Okay, so it will be easier for them to do it with. Okay, you can see A, 2 slanting line, 1 sleeping line, E, 1 standing line, 3 sleeping lines. So while you teach your kid, make them understand that suppose A, they have to put 2 slanting line, 1 sleeping line. So you keep them saying while they write, so that it will go to their mind, and while they write independently, it will come to your mind. Okay, mama said 2 sleeping line, 1 sleeping line, 2 slanting line, 1 sleeping line. So which makes their work very easier. So please follow all this. Definitely they will write it better. So dear parents, today we have discussed about 15 alphabets, and the other alphabets I'll be discussing in my other video. So please watch that video. Thank you.